I'm the only thing hopping like a kangaroo. I mean, the only thing popping like a can of brew. Listen, you should buy a 16 cause I write it good. The 808 woof woof cause I write it good. And bitches can't funny men cause I write it good. I'm the wolf, where is that I write it good.
And told him bring his hood back from the ghetto. And my bitch super bougie and the kickback is stilettos. Ain't fuck with me back then, but when she see me, she say hello. My game ain't...
Pop all late night, baby girl, okay. It wasn't a plan, baby girl, ha ha ha.
Skeet the beat, carry the bus like Greed the Freak. She suck dick on me.
Hold on, homie. Hey, homie.
Don't get mad. Take your bitch, nigga.
I testify for you. I do that 3-4 times again. I testify for you. I told her that I kill that bitch. I do what all of them around you scared to do. I'm not. Long as you just been out here for me, I got it. My bitch scheming, looting, hot your body. Long as you dreaming about me, ain't no problem. I don't got nobody just with you right now. Tell the truth, look better under you. I can't lose, yeah, when I'm with you. How can I snooze and miss the moment? You just too important. Nobody, nobody like you do. Can't lose when I'm with you. I can't just snooze and miss the moment. You just too important. Nobody, nobody like you do. Yeah. Sex reminds you I'm not violent. I'm your day one. Sex reminds you I'm not violent, I'm your day one. Yeah.
I feel, and this is my personal opinion, that so many STEM-related classes feel the need to be weed-out classes. Like, they're literally called weed-out classes. But I truly think if the professors had the capacity to actually be able to teach, because I truly think that not every professor is meant to be a teacher, so many more students would stay within the major. Because I truly feel that so many of my classes my freshman year were kind of self-taught, but also just seeking resources outside my class because the class in and of itself was not helpful. So I was going to multiple different tutoring sessions a week, talking to my peers to see how they understand the material, just literally anything to just grasp what was going on because I really wanted to pursue my major. And maybe you could say I got better, I got smarter throughout my years of college, but I will say I did not have to do the near amount of work as I got more in depth in my major because I felt like those professors actually knew how to teach what we needed to learn.
Today, I'm going to attempt a leotard. This will be a challenge because do I know anything about fashion? No. Can I dress? No. Anything cool in my wardrobe? No. But do I care? No. Now, Aaliyah did drop a whole tutorial literally for the boys, so I'm gonna take inspo from one of her more feminine looks. First up, fishnets. Got it for $8 at Target, and when I did, an older African man said, Uncle, I'm sorry. Hey, either way, we'll put this on at the top. I have this crop top my friend got me a couple years ago. He said it fits me figuratively and literally. But I don't like to wear it because it has a bad word on it. For belts, I have a couple different belts, but at Target, I also saw this belt that had a heart buckle. I thought it was adorable. For shoes, I got my knockoff Tims. And y'all should be more appreciative that you don't have La Cienega feet like I do. Moon boots don't come in men's size 13. I don't have earmuffs, but I feel like these ski goggles are like Aaliyah core adjacent. And for fur, I thrifted a fur jacket for $10. While putting on the fur jacket, I tore a massive hole in it. So I think I'm gonna cut off the sleeves and turn it into a $10 fur vest. Everything over some black jeans. Then I'll probably sag a bit, cause sagging's kinda gay. And as a bisexual, I'm by definition kind of gay.
Here's what we got. I have the fur vest right here. I'm gonna put it on, but I feel like when you have sleeves and a vest and long sleeves, it's kind of busy. So I might roll these up, just so you can see my guns that way.
Yeah.
And we're done. I had a lot of fun doing this. And that's all that fucking matters. Now, it's not Aaliyah core if you don't go out and wear it and feel confident in it. So I'm gonna go to 7-Eleven. I'll see y'all later.
Y'all better come get one of these. It's not a chicken salad.
It is tatale, a soft plantain pancake from Ghana. We are starting with the same spice mix for my kiliwili recipe, grinding that and setting it aside. Then I grinded some onions, ginger, and scotch bonnet pepper till smooth and reincorporated my spice mix. Then I moved on to mash my overripe plantains till I got a semi-smooth paste. Once I got to that point, I reincorporated my onion spice mix, some salt, mixed everything together, and added some all-purpose flour for some body. These are traditionally fried in red palm oil. You want to keep the heat at medium low so that the palm oil doesn't burn and that the pancakes actually cook through. So you want to make sure to keep an eye on the heat and keep adding in some more palm oil as you cook the plantains. Once everything was nice and cooked, I served it with some bambara beans, which are African groundnuts that are usually stewed for hours. This is a perfect plant-based meal straight from Ghana. The full recipe is on my blog.
Bitches be nasty, all on the floor, shaking ass cheeks, underarms smelling like an athlete. Don't walk past me, dirty ass hoe got me gagging. Everything popping but a fashion. Hoes be trifling, wonder why a nigga won't wife him. Wonder why a nigga won't night him. Stupid little bitch, came to the club for a nigga. And a nigga end up leaving with a bitch. How you silly, I won't let a nigga near me. But I'ma make sure a nigga hear me. I get money, I'm a boss bitch, you a dummy. I be calling shots, niggas love me. I need pesos, real big cheese or queso. I'm burning up, I'm Fuego. Bitches better lay low.
Oops, got your coping skills. Now let's see what we got. That's not a coping skill.
Your love got the best of me. And baby, you're making a fool of me. You got me strong and I don't care who sees. Baby, you got me. You got me.
Guys, say this with me. Gone are the days.
Gone are the days.
Where you can talk to the gays. Any kind of ways. All right, have a good day.
Organic olive oil.
tried dipping, he begged me to stay. Bae, I'm not staying, I just wanna play. In the party, he just wanna rum. Big boobs in the bus, they plump. She a baddie, she know she a 10. She a baddie with her baddie friend.
Tonight is your birthday. Let's blow out all the candles. Yeah, we could get romantic as long as I'm with you.
You are not on my level.
The winner of GQ Supermodel Model of the Year, Miss Bella Hadid.
Doctor out of London has made the claim that Bella Hadid is the most beautiful woman on earth.
And the sky be black and white, and the sun be black and yellow. That's the same way you show me. Close the eyes and I think about blessings for the.
Fuck your bitch in the clique you claim. Westside, when we ride, come on quick, we gang. You claim to be a player, but I fucked your wife. We bust them bad boys, niggas fuck for life.
Fire me, she don't speak English. I'm getting there to let you know I'm an innocent, and no, I'm not picking your shit. I didn't hold you to hold me, got your new hobby, even the pussy.
In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I'm too late, the life to the sing. In this very moment, I bring put down everything. That I will retire with a ring. And I will retire with a crown.
Yes.
No, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed.
Yes.
Clap for the way you ain't set me. But I do it all alone.
We.
Straight men, what do you get out of changing the pronouns of a perfectly good song? And queer people, this is not about you. You keep doing that shit. I love that. I eat it up like a junior bacon 4 for 4. You're trying to prove something, babe, and it's not working. So let's stop that, okay?
Last year, I got promoted. I got promoted to director. Supposed to be a good thing. Supposed to be a good thing. It's something that I had asked for. Something in the end that I demanded, quite frankly, yes. Because I was doing the job. I said, I'm doing the job. I deserve the title and the pay. And so I got promoted, yes. I spent a year dealing with white women, reminding them that they defer to me on my clients because I'm in charge of my clients. Yes. Dealing with white men because it is my clients and I'm in charge of the strategy, and that I was hired to repair the damage done to the relationship because, to quote my previous director, if anybody could, I could repair the damaged relationship because I have a proven track record of doing so. Yeah. But regardless of my proven track record, regardless of my stellar reviews, I was ran over repeatedly by white directors, senior directors, and AVPs. Yes. I had to use my customer service voice so often that I got a headache. I had to talk with a smile on my face so that nobody knew that I was enraged as they continually attempted to usurp my authority. And I literally just got out of a meeting where the only person who knew the answer was me. And once again, I was repeatedly ignored and talked over. And we don't want to even talk about the fact that I've got a client who likes everything about me as long as it's coming from a white person. They hired me to fix a problem, yet do not support me in any way, shape, or fashion to fix the problem. And then they wonder why I'm so frustrated and angry. I'm confused by their confusion. So apparently, this is a thing, yeah. I mean, aside from the blatant misogynoir, right? Yeah, we've talked about that. The misogynoir, the hatred, prejudiced, ingrained dislike of black women. Yeah, that is a thing. We've talked about that before. But hiring black women to fix a problem and then providing absolutely no support, that's a thing. It has a name, and it's called glass cliff. Yeah, yeah. I learned about that a few weeks ago. And I'm going to do additional research, see what else I can find out, and share my findings. Yeah, yeah. See if it can tell me how not to flip out in the middle of a meeting. Yeah.
Here in this dimension, you and I are meant to be. I have waited lifetimes to find you. Now that you're here, I can remind you of the things you've been dreaming times.
Don't care, I guess I gotta go. I guess it's time to go.
If you have a bonnet on, I'm not watching your video.
Street saying your baby father 18 and you 30. You start worrying about these bonnets and start worrying about what time school let out because you got two people to pick up. You got to give your baby and your baby father lunch money. You worried about bonnets. Make it make sense. Prioritize.
Hold up. Come back. I'm trying to see something. Look at the camera. Pose. Just what I thought. That's a bad bitch right there. That's a bad bitch. That's a bad bitch. You a bad bitch. Yes, baby.
You just don't get it.
How you deal with all this trauma?
I will call my mama.
That's beautiful, man.
Call my mama a bitch.
Oh.
Him though, I'd rather be in hell than alone.
I love him, but I gotta kill him. I love him, I love him, but I gotta kill him. I love him, I love him, I love him, but I gotta kill him. But I gotta kill him.
Finally, they're opening up the gates. They'll be actual real life people. It'll be totally strange. Wow, am I so ready for this change? 'Cause for the first time in forever, there'll be music, there'll be light. For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through the night. Don't know if I'm elated or gassy, but I'm somewhere in that zone. 'Cause for the first time in forever.
can't wait to meet everyone.
I'm the only thing hopping like a kangaroo. I mean, the only thing popping like a can of brew. Listen, you should buy a 16 cause I write it good. The 808 woof woof cause I write it good. And bitches can't funny man cause I write it good. I'm the wolf, whoever that I write, I'm writing hard.
In the hood, I'm like Princess Diana. I'm thick cause I be eating oats. Bitch not taking shit from me but notes. Wanna be me so she do my emotes and my name in her mouth, so I bet she gon' choke. Tell her man I'm the girl of his dreams. Think about me when
I know the guy on here that said he was Michael Jackson running trains. Keke Palmer just made a hate video on him. I've gotten hate from a couple of celebrities. And then you're like, oh, okay, whatever. That kind of sucks. I don't care. But I mean this from the bottom of my spirit. If the love of my life, Keke Palmer, made a hate video on me, I swear to God, I'm deleting my fucking channel. I love Timothy Chalamet, but I will fight Timothy Chalamet with all my might over Keke Palmer.
My daughter asked me for a loan from the Bank of Mom. And when I told her she didn't meet the qualifications for one, that girl replied, I thought this was a black-owned business. Wait, you gotta give her a loan, because please.
You wanna ask, don't you, what you wanna know? You're moving fast, but I wanna...
When I'm banners, calling my phone, but they know I don't answer. Why? In the hood, I'm like Princess Diana. I'm thick cause I be eating oats. Huh? Bitch not taking shit from me but notes. Wanna be me, so she do my emotes and my name in her mouth, so I bet she gon'.
Dear diary, I'm in my Lori Harvey era. If one won't work, get another one. Like Hip Hop Harry said, who's next? In Lori Harvey, we trust. XOXO, Brent.
Being a housewife is not a reward. Being a woman of leisure is a reward.
Well, that's the same thing.
No, they're not. No, they're not. If you're a woman of leisure, if you are a woman of leisure, you don't have responsibilities. Your responsibility is being a woman of leisure. If you are a housewife, you maintain and you manage the house. That's not a fucking reward. It's a job. Whether it's only 20 hours a week, is still a job.
If there's no
kids, if you're trying to reward me because I was there through the tough times, let me be a woman of leisure. Let me be a kept woman. That is a reward. Rewarding me with washing dishes is not a fucking reward.
I still love him though. I'd rather be in hell than alone.
I love him, but I gotta kill him. I love him, I love him, but I gotta kill him. I love him, I love him, I love him, but I gotta kill him.
I can tell that internalized misogyny and just misogyny is really eating some of y'all up, because you're telling me, oh my God, you're gonna end up alone, no man's gonna love you. Baby, I'm gay. The man was never the prize.
You know, you know.
You read it in her voice too, did you? If you know, you know. We out ya.
Like a relay race. When I run up in the spot, get to know they place. Slide on a nigga, I'ma need my skates. Social distance, I'ma need my space. I done did it, I won with it. I made peace with myself.
They getting fucked up tonight.
Right, I'm not funny. I don't have to be a clown. Not everybody has to be funny. If everyone was as funny as the people on TV, there'd be no reason to watch TV. And if nobody watched TV, all the people who make the shows would have no jobs, and all the companies that advertise would go out of business. So by not being funny, I'm saving the jobs of thousands and thousands of people and their families.
Being followed around in a furniture store is so funny, because you really looked at me and said, yeah,
This bitch looks like she could fit a coffee table in her pocket. Let me watch her.
How about some good news? You may have missed it, but these two women of color just made history. While most of the country was worried about who would control Congress, these two women were kicking down barriers and shattering glass ceilings. First is Summer Lee. She's a Democrat and the first Black woman to be elected to Congress from Pennsylvania, which feels extremely overdue. She ran on a progressive platform that included democracy, disability justice, and environmental justice. Second is Delia Ramirez. She's also a progressive Democrat and the first Latina to be elected to Congress from the state of Illinois. She ran on Medicare for All. She's the daughter of Guatemalan immigrants. We just got two really dope representatives in Congress. These profoundly intelligent and capable leaders are blazing a trail, one that I hope many more women will be inspired to walk down.